Good morning, my colleagues. The lecture today is about gelminthiasis. We will speak about clinic, pathogenesis, etiology, epidemiology, diagnostic and treatments of gelminthiasis. Now you see there are 250 types of gelminths, and there are geogelminths, biogelminths, contact gelminthiasis. Geogelminths characterized by developments of invasive eggs in the ground. Biogelminths characterized by developments of invasive eggs in organism of animals. And contact gelminthiasis characterized by developments of invasive eggs in organism of the patients, in intestinal of the patients. Yes, and there are some stage of infection. Acute stage lasts from 2 up to 4 weeks. Latent stage and chronic stage lasts many months, many years in the patients. So let's speak about general clinic symptoms of infection of gelminthiasis. So acute stage characterized by migration of gelminths. When gelminths penetrate to intestinal system, sometimes to blood, to stomach, to intestinal, to blood vessels. Yes, and then formation of blood circulation when gelminths penetrate to different organs, liver, lungs, muscles, brain, and then it causes the formation of secondary focus of infection. Then symptoms of gelminthiasis characterized by larval migrants, characterized by subfebrile temperature, exanthems, itching of skins, eosinophilic infiltration of the lung. So it's characterized by subfebrile temperature, sometimes asthenic syndrome, syndrome of intoxication. Then gelminths penetrate to the lung and cause the formation of eosinophilic granulomas in the lung, formation of eosinophilic pneumonia, clinic of bronchitis and bronchopneumonia, dyspnea, dry cough, so sometimes productive cough. Yes. Sometimes formation of toxic allergic syndrome, itching of skin, increasing of permeability of blood vessels, and formation of rash on the skin, migration rash on the skin. Sometimes gelminths penetrate to the liver and formation of eosinophilic granulomas in the liver, which causes the destruction of hepatocytes, increasing of bilirubin, transaminase, and hepatomegaly. Then sometimes gelminths penetrate to the muscle tissue and cause granulomas, infection granulomas in the muscles, is characterized by myalgia. Sometimes gelminths penetrate to hematoencephalic barrier and cause formation of meningitis, meningoencephalitis, paresis, paralysis, disorders of consciousness. So then formation of latent phase and chronic phase of infection may be different outcomes of gelminthiasis, sometimes recovering and residual forms of infection. Dystrophia of internal organs, dystrophia of myocard, dystrophia of the lung, so disorders of function of the lung, of the liver. Yes, and sometimes, so maybe chronic forms and recovering of the patients. So at first, we'll speak about trichineliosis. It is gelminths class nematoda, infection agent Trichinella spiralis. So you see secondary focus of infection in the muscles, formation of infection granulomas in the muscles. Класс нематода, yes. Trichinella spiralis. Maybe Trichinella nativa. Sources of infection is animals. Maybe agricultural animals. You see, for example, pigs, bears, wild animals, foxes, bears, sometimes rodents may be sources of infection. More often pigs, sources of infection is pigs, meat of pigs, which invasive of Trichinella spiralis. Alimentary ways of transmission. So two variants of guillemins, Trichinella spiralis and Trichinella nativa. Trichinella nativa cause severe forms of infection. So oral mechanism of transmission, formation of parasitemia, characterized by formation of immunosuppressions, suppressions of immune response, T lymphocytes, phagocytosis, and cause prolonged parasitemia when invasive eggs, formation of larva migrans, when guillemins penetrate to different organs, to internal organs, to the muscles, to the lung, to the brain, and formation of secondary focus of infection. Formation of fibrosic capsules in the muscles. After 3-4 weeks after invasion, synthesis of antibodies. And let's speak about clinic of trichinellosis characterized by fever, intoxication, sometimes prolonged fever, muscle pain because formation secondary focus of infection in the muscles, edema of the face, sometimes intoxication, headache, nausea, vomiting, formation of rash on the skin, sometimes urticaria rash, itching of skin, maybe sore throat, catarrh syndrome. In the lung, we indicate eosinophilic infiltration, dry cough, dyspnea, spasm of bronchus, and eosinophilic infiltration. So eosinophilia in blood, for example, 30-40% of eosinophils. At the severe forms, we indicate high fever, intoxication. The fever lasts from 2 up to 4 weeks. Hemosis, diplopia, exophthalm, edema of brain, agitation, disorders of sleeping, delirium, hallucination. Sometimes cramps, muscle pain, contracture of muscles, hemorrhagical rash, diarrhea, at the severe forms, increasing of the level of eosinophils, 80-90%. Maybe mild, moderate, and severe forms, and at the severe forms may be edema of lung, edema of brain, toxic shock, disseminated hemorrhagical syndrome. Diagnostic of infection characterized by anamnesis of the patients, alimentary anamnesis for example, meat from pigs, from bears, clinical acute forms of infection, fever, rash, meningia, eosinophilic infiltration of the lung, bronchitis, the methods of indication of confirmal diagnosis is ELISA when we indicate antibodies after 14-15 days after infection. Maximal titer of antibodies synthesis after 4-5 weeks after beginning of infection. And treatments of trichinellosis, we administer mebendazole 5 mg on 1 kg of mass of patients from 5 up to 10 days. Tiabendazole from 25 up to 30 mg on 1 kg from 5 up to 10 days. Albendazole dose is 10 mg on 1 kg during 7 days. Invasive eggs, meat, you see on the picture, invasive meat. So it is factors of transmission of infection, alimentary ways of transmission. Trichinelloscope for indication of invasive granulomas in the muscles. Trichinelloscope for diagnostic of trichinellosis. Next, gilmitiasis, class nematoda, toxocariasis. Etiology of infection is toxocariocanis, class nematoda. Sources of infection, dogs, maybe wolf, fox, canine family. Mechanism of infection, oral. Maybe geophagia in anamnesis of the patient. Oral mechanism of transmission when invasive eggs penetrate to intestinal system and formation larval migrants, migration of parasites in the blood, in blood circulation. Formation of hemorrhagia, necrosis, inflammatory alteration in the different organs. Maybe cutaneous forms, eyes forms, maybe visceral forms of infection. Invasive eggs penetrate to blood, formation of larval migrants, circulation infection in the blood. Increasing of permeability of blood vessels when parasites penetrate to tissue and formation of secondary eosinophilic granulomas in internal organs. In the liver, lung, eyes, brains. Activation of migration of phagocytes, macrophages around invasive parasites and formation of eosinophilic granulomas. Localization of infection granulomas characterized by clinic forms and symptoms of toxocariasis. Eosinophilic granulomas localize in the liver, lung, pancreas, myocard, localize in mesenteric lymphatic nodes in the brain. And formation of eosinophilic granulomatosis, formation of eosinophilic granulomas in different organs. Such clinical classification of toxocariasis indicates skin forms, visceral forms, eyes forms, central forms of infection. Skin form characterized by fever, rash, urticaria rash, maybe polymorphal rash, itching of skin. Visceral forms characterized by clinic of pneumonia, клетников пневмония, зенофилик пневмония, dry cough, dyspnea, and infiltration of the lung. Maybe destruction of hepatocytes and formation of secondary hepatitis, sometimes increasing of bilirubin and transaminase. Sometimes parasites migration to retina and cause destruction of the eyes. Formation of eye forms, iridocyclitis, chorioretinitis, panophthalmitis, disorders of vision of the patients. Formation of panophthalmitis. Yes, and central forms because invasive eggs penetrate to the brain, migration to hematoencephalic barrier and penetrate to central nervous system cause destruction of neurons and formation of focus of destruction, formation of neurological syndrome, cramps, disorders of consciousness, mental disorders of the patients. Diagnostic of infection, ELISA methods, immune enzyme analysis, when we indicate antibodies, titer of antibodies 800. And it is very important anamnesis of the patients, contact with dogs, contact with animals, yes, in anamnesis. And treatments of toxocariasis. So we can administer thiabendazole 25 mg and 1 kg of mass of patients during 10 days. Mebendazole 5 mg and 1 kg during 1 month. Zitrazine from 2 up to 6 mg on 1 kg from 2 up to 4 weeks. Albendazole, it is a modern antihelminthic medicate. Dose is 10 mg on 1 kg from 10 up to 20 days. Then we repeat the treatments. We administer next course of the treatments after 2 weeks. And prevention of infections, so diagnostic toxocariasis in animals, diagnostic toxocariasis in dogs, examination of the dogs, and treatment of the dogs. You see invasive eggs, syndrome larva migrans, migration of helminths in the blood, toxocarcinis, class nematoda. Toxocarcinis from animals of the dogs, from intestinal of the dogs. Now, my colleagues, you see that there are many helminthiasis class of nematoda, ascariasis, enterobiasis, ankylostomidosis, trichocephalosis, strongyloidosis. So let's continue such characteristic of those helminthiasis. So next infection, next helminth, Ascaris lumbricoides, class nematoda, cause formation ascariasis, which cause the destruction of intestinal of the patients. So oral mechanism of transmission, it is geogelmintosis, formation of invasive eggs in the ground, sources of transmission, vegetables, berries, may be contact alimentary ways of transmission. And guilmins penetrate to intestinal system, penetrate to the stomach, then penetrate to intestinal, then penetrate to blood, formation of larva migrans, migration of invasive agent in the blood, and then invasive agent penetrate to the lung and formation of eosinophilic granules, trichoph, dyspnea, productive cone. Then guilmins again penetrate to intestinal system, to the stomach, to intestinal, and localize in intestinal, in large intestinal of the patients, and so formation of chronic forms of infection, reproduction of guilmins, and migration of guilmins in different organs. So invasive guilmins penetrate to bile ducts, to pancreas, to appendix, sometimes to bronchus, so and formation of clinic of complications of ascariasis. Then guilmins penetrate to intestinal and reproduction in intestinal, synthesis toxins, cause inflammation of mucous membrane of intestinal, and formation of diarrhea, abdominal pain, intestinal colic, spasm of intestinal. So migration of guilmins, and you see migration guilmins, migration ascaris to respiratory system, to oral, yes, and sometimes formation of necrosis of intestinal, perforation of intestinal, developments of peritonitis, for example, intestinal colic, maybe bile colic, pain in right iliac region when guilmins migrate to bile ducts. Sometimes guilmins migrate to pancreas, formation of abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting. Sometimes guilmins migrate to respiratory system and cause obstructive tracheal bronchitis, dyspnea, so formation of mechanical obstruction of respiratory system. Diagnostic of ascariasis is coprogelmintoscopia, microscopia of feces when we indicate invasive effects of guilmins. Next, guilmintiasis, enterobiasis, contact, oral mechanism of transmission. Sometimes respiratory mechanism of transmission. Enterobius vermicularis, class nematoda, contact, guilmintiasis, because cycle of life of guilmins, formation in intestinal of the patients, and maybe contact mechanism of transmission. Sources of infection is patients, and then from the patients, invasive guilmins penetrate to toys, to hands, yes, and maybe outer invasion, and then maybe invasion other patients, other children, for example. So, and oral mechanism of transmission, when invasive acts penetrate to intestinal system, then invasive eggs penetrate to large intestinal, formation of gelmins in large intestinal, and then migration of gelmins, for example, to anus, to sexual organs, to appendix, and sometimes it causes mechanical disorders, irritation of mucous membrane, inflammation of mucous membrane, formation of erosia, hemorrhagia of intestinal, sometimes formation of infection granulomas in intestinal, formation of purulent complication of infection. Sometimes migration of gelmins to sexual organs and formation of vulvovaginitis and endometritis. In the evening, invasive eggs migration to anus, and it causes itching of anus in the evening, in the night, and it causes the formation paraproctitis, rectitis, inflammation of rectum. Yes, and so which clinic of enterobiasis characterized by asthenic syndrome, sometimes subfebrility temperature, and itching of anus. Sometimes gelmins penetrate to appendix and formation of appendicitis, formation of peritonitis, formation of syndrome of diarrhea with pathological admixtures. And methods of diagnostic of enterobiasis, it is smear from anus, when we indicate invasive eggs of gelmins. Next, gelminciasis is ankylostomidosis, oral and contact mechanism of transmission. Invasive eggs, ankylostoma duodenale, geogelmintosis, class nematoda. Factors of transmission is vegetables, dirty hands, maybe. Ways of transmission, maybe contact ways of transmission in cases of wound of skin. So ankylostoma duodenale can penetrate to skin, then penetrate to blood vessels and formation of parasitemia. And oral mechanism of transmission, so penetration to gastrointestinal syndrome, then penetrate to blood, then migration of blood circulation, formation of eosinophilic granulomas, dyspnea, bronchitis, eosinophilic pneumonia. Then gelmins penetrate to gastrointestinal system and penetrate to the stomach and penetrate to duodenum. Reproduction in duodenum, penetration to blood vessels, synthesis exotoxins, formation of erosia and ulcers of mucous membrane of duodenum, and formation of syndrome of abdominal syndrome, abdominal pain in epigastrium, pain in right iliac region, so maybe a clinic of ulcers of duodenum. Maybe perforation of the ulcer and clinic of peritonitis. And ankylostoma duodenale is gametophag and it causes phagocytes and destruction of erythrocytes, and it causes the formation of anemia. And clinic of ankylostomidosis may be wound of skin, hyperemia around the wound, and then blood circulation eosinophilic pneumonia, dry cough, dyspnea, then clinic of duodenitis, abdominal pain, pain in epigastrium, pain in right subcostal region, clinic of ulcers of duodenum. So maybe toxic allergic syndrome, rash on the skin, papule rash, polymorphal rash, and itching of skin. Diagnostic of infection characterized by such methods, the same methods, copragelmintoscopia, microscopia of feces, when we indicate invasive acts of gelmints. Next, strongyloidosis, class nematoda, oral mechanism of transmission, invasive infection agent, strongyloides tercaralis, may be oral and contact mechanism of transmission. You see on the picture, yes, gelmints, strongyloides tercaralis. And oral mechanism of transmission when gelmints penetrate to intestinal system, reproduction in intestinal, cause the syndrome of enteritis, gastroenteritis, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, rash on the skin, toxico-allergic syndrome. Then maybe clinic eosinophilic infiltration of the lung, clinic of bronchitis, and maybe contact mechanism of transmission, wound of skins, inflammation around the skin, and around the wound of skin. Maybe toxico-allergic syndrome, syndrome of pneumonia, syndrome of gastroduodenitis, syndrome of enterocolitis, and toxico-allergic syndrome, when formation rash of the skin. Diagnostic of infection is coproscopia, microscopia of feces, when we indicate invasive acts of gelmints. Next, gelmintiasis class nematoda is trichocephalosis, trichocephalus trichiorus, geogelmintosis, class nematoda, spread in hot countries with in the countries with hot climate, tropical climate maybe. It is gelmints, class nematoda. You see the picture of trichocephalus trichiorus. Geogelmintosis, anthraponosis. So sources of infection is patients. You see gelmints and invasive facts of gelmints. On microscopia, yes, of the feces, we indicate such variant of infection. So, oral mechanism of transmission when gelmints penetrate to intestinal syndrome penetrate cause syndrome of enterocolitis because invasive gelmints penetrate to bile ducts, cause destruction of erythrocytes, formation of anemia, synthesis of toxins, and cause inflammation of intestinal system, hyperemia, edema, hemorrhagia of intestinal, spasm of intestinal, intestinal colic, maybe nausea, vomiting, diarrhea with mucus admixtures and blood admixtures. Oral contact mechanism of transmission, factors of transmission may be alimentary products and dirty hands. Now, my colleagues, diagnostic of trichocephalosis, coproscopia, microscopia of feces, when we indicate invasive X. Yes, when we indicate invasive X. Now, my colleagues, we spoke about some gelmintiasis, ascariasis, entrobiasis, ankylostomidosis, strongyloidosis, trichocephalosis. Let's speak about the treatments of such gelmintiasis. So, nimazole, yes, the main antigelmintic medicate, nimazole or sonaxal dose 40 mg per day for adult patients. For children, we indicate such dose 10 mg on 1 kg of mass of the patients. And antigelmintic treatment lasts 2 or 3 days. Then after 2 weeks, we repeat the treatments. We repeat the treatments. The same dose, so 400 mg per day during 2-3 days again for prevention of relapse of infection. So, next invasion, next gelmintiasis, epistorchiasis, class trematoda, maybe natural focus of infection. Yes, and our region is natural focus of infection because we have two big rivers, Volga and Aka. Because factors of transmission of epistorchiasis is fish product. Epistorchis salineus, class trematoda, sources of infection, patients, cats, fox, dogs, maybe intermediate hosts, freshwater mollusks, and additional hosts, carping fish. So, factors of transmission of Epistorchis salineus, carping fish. So, oral mechanism of transmission when Epistorchis salineus penetrate to intestinal system, to the stomach, then to bile ducts, penetration to bile ducts and cause inflammation and destruction of bile ducts. Block of the bile, inflammation of mucous membrane of the bile ducts, formation of destruction cholangitis, cholecystitis, sometimes formation of destruction of hepatocytes, disorders of the function of the liver, hyperbilirubinemia, cetolysis, increasing of transaminase, abdominal pain, hepatomegaly. Maybe inflammation of pancreas, formation of the clinic of acute pancreatitis, destruction of biliary system, destruction of mucous membrane, formation of atrophia of mucous membrane or hypertrophia, formation of, for example, proliferation of epithelium of bile ducts, and sometimes it causes formation of cirrhosis of the liver, fibrosis of the liver, and malignization of bile ducts, formation of cancer of the liver. So the severe forms, formation of parasitic cirrhosis, fibrosis of the liver, and malignization of bile ducts. Sometimes activation of secondary infection and formation of bacterial cholangitis and cholecystitis. So, and the clinic of infection may be initial period of formation of toxic allergic syndrome, itching of skin, eosinophilic infiltration of the lung, then formation syndrome of cholangitis, cholecystitis, hepatomegaly, abdominal pain, pain in right subcostal region, the pain in upper so in left subcostal region, in mesogastrium, and clinic of cholecystitis, cholangitis, duodenitis, sometimes syndrome of jaundice, intoxication, maybe increasing of the temperature. And sometimes formation such complications, for example, abscess of the liver, bacterial cholangitis, rupture of parasitic cyst, peritonitis, and malignization of bile ducts, formation of primary cancer of the liver and cancer of bile ducts. Diagnostic of epistrochiasis, microscopy of bile, coproscopia when the indication invasive effects, so blood picture when we indicate eosinophilia, sometimes inflammation alteration of blood, leukocytosis, neutrophilosis, hyperbilirubinemia, cytolysis. But main methods of indication is microscopy of bile when we indicate invasive effects of epistrochis filinensis. Sometimes invasive effects we indicate in the feces by methods of coproscopia. And treatments of infection, praxiquantel, 50 mg on 1 kg, one day, one time. Then after 2 weeks, we repeat the treatments. Then examination of the patients after 1 or 2 months. So after 2 months, we can indicate effect of the treatments of the patients. Next, fasciolysis, class trematoda, invasive agent fasciola hepatica, oral mechanism of transmission, sources of infection is patients and rodents maybe, and agricultural animals. Maybe intermediate host is selfish. Factors of transmission of infection is vegetables, berries, dirty hands. Fasciola hepatica penetrate to intestinal system, then penetrate to stomach, bile ducts, cause inflammation of bile ducts, and formation the clinic of cholangitis, destruction of bile ducts, activation of secondary infection, maybe hepatomegaly, hyperbilirubinemia, jaundice, cytolysis, intoxication, abdominal pain, pain in right subcostal region. Sometimes cause malignization of the liver, malignization of bile ducts, formation of parasitic cirrhosis and liver insufficiency. The same diagnostic, clinic, anamnesis, jaundice, cytolysis, hepatomegaly, intoxication, and indication means in the bile, microscopy of bile, microscopy of feces when we indicate invasive effects of guilmins. And the same treatments of fasciolysis, praxiquantel, 50 mg on 1 kg of mass of the patients, and then secondary treatments, next course of the treatments after 2 weeks. And the examination of the patients, control examinations after 1 or 2 months. Next text class echinococcosis. Next gelmintosis echinococcosis class. Cestoda biogelmintosis. Sources of infection is animals: dogs, wolf, fox. Echinococcus granulosis class cestoda. Sources of infection: dogs, wolf, fox, jackal. Intermedial host: patients from animals. Parasitic cysts are formed in different organs, in the liver, lung, muscle, spleen, bone. More often, parasitic cysts cause the formation in the liver in 70%, in the lung in 20%. Sources of infection is pets, dogs, wolf, jackal. Yes, and internal organs cause the formation of parasitic cyst, echinococcal cyst, which characterized by such structure of echinococcal cyst. So cuticular membrane or hyaline plate, germinative membrane and fibrous capsules. Such characteristic of parasitic echinococcal cyst. Pathogenesis of infection characterized by the first phase is allergic phase, phase of sensibilization of macroorganism, when formation of asthenic syndrome, rash of the skin, toxicoallergic syndrome, eosinophilic infiltration. Then formation of chronic forms of infection when invasive effects penetrate to internal organs, to the liver, lung, brain, formation of parasitic cyst. Then, when formation of parasitic cyst in the liver, in the lung, it's characterized by increasing of the cyst, and it causes the mechanical compression and disorders of the function of internal organs. So, it causes the formation of fibrosis of the liver, fibrosis of the lung, liver insufficiency, respiratory insufficiency, maybe atrophy of hepatocytes, maybe necrosis of hepatocytes, maybe formation of fibrosis and cirrhosis of the liver, portal hypertension. Sometimes it will characterized by formation of parasitic pneumonia, parasitic cyst in the lung, infiltration in the lung, dyspnea, respiratory insufficiency. Sometimes invasive effects penetrate to the brain and formation of parasitic cyst in the brain and formation of neurological syndrome, paresis, paralysis, disorders of consciousness, chronic cramps, mental disorders, maybe in clinic and pathogenesis of echinococcosis. Uh, stage of infection, inducional stage, then uncomplicated stage, complicated stage. So, initial stage characterized by toxicologic syndrome, self-fibrillated temperature, asthenic syndrome, itching of skin, rash on the skin. Uncomplicated stage of inflammation parasitic cyst in the liver characterized by hepatomegaly, sometimes dyspnea. Yes, and complicated stage when formation of parasitic cyst and formation of mechanical jaundice, abscess of the liver, anaphylactic shock, dissemination forms of infection when formation after destruction of the cyst, dissemination of infection and formation of secondary metastatic focus of infection in different organs. In the liver, lung, brain of the patients. And diagnostic of infection, contact with animals, for example, contact with dogs. Yes, and КТ, МРТ, X-ray, ultrasonic methods of examination when we indicate parasitic cyst. Yes, and then indication of antibodies by methods of ELISA. And then treatments of the patients, surgical methods of treatments, rejection of parasitic cyst from the liver, lung, brain. And then anti-helminthic treatment. Anti-helminthic treatment before surgical invasion and after surgical invasion. Prevention of dissemination forms of infection. So we recommend albendazole or nimazole 10 mg on 1 kg. During 4 weeks, then secondary course after 2 weeks. And dispensarization of the patients during many years, control test, control ultrasonic methods, КТ, МРТ, every 6 months for prevention of formation of dissemination process and formation of metastatic focus of infection, metastatic cyst in different organs, and control of titer of antibodies, yes, and sometimes maybe increasing of the titer is characterized by reactivation of infection. So we recommend some course of the treatments. So 2-3 course of albendazole during 4 weeks for prevention of reactivation of helminthiasis. So you see Echinococcus granulosus in the liver, formation of parasitic cyst in the liver, morphological result. So morphological result, parasitic cyst in the liver. Parasitic cyst, many cysts of the liver. Ultrasonic methods of examination, you see parasitic cyst. You see parasitic cyst, yes, many secondary cysts in big echinococcal cyst by ultrasonic methods. In the lung, localized in the lung, so characterized by parasitic pneumonia, dyspnea, infiltration of the lung, and indication of parasitic cyst. morphological result of echinococcal cyst. So my colleagues, we differentiate echinococcosis and alveolococcosis because alveolococcosis is characterized by the same clinical system. Infection agent is Alveococcus multicularis, and sources of infection is animals, two dogs, wolf, and the oral mechanism of transmission, and it's characterized by formation of parasitic cyst in internal organs. But in alveolococcosis, we indicate many parasitic cysts, and very quickly progressive of formation of metastatic focus of infection. So it's characterized by formation of metastatic focus in the liver, lung, brain, different localization of parasitic cyst. And the same methods of diagnostic and treatments, so indication, parasitic focus by methods of ultrasonic methods, CAT, MRT, X-ray, when we indication parasitic cyst, ELISA methods for indication of antibodies, and then surgical methods of the treatments, removal parasitic cyst, alveococcal cyst, and then anticholinergic treatment before and after surgical invasion. And anticholinergic treatment lasts all the life of the patients in cases of alveolococcosis. The same methods of treatments, albendazole, nemazole, 10 mg on 1 kg of mass of patients. Now let's speak about gelmintiasis class cystoda. You see, cysticercosis is an invasive X. Infection agent is Tenia solium, cause formation of gelmints in intestinal and formation of cysticerc in internal organs. The sources of infection is meat of pigs, cause the formation of mature gelmints and formation of cysticerc. You see, Tenia solium. Класс цистода. Tenia solium. Класс цистода. You see cysticercosis of the brain. Cysticercosis of the brain. Tenia rhynchosis. Infection agent. Tenia-rhynchus saginatus. Tenia-rhynchus saginatus. Tenia-rhynchus saginatus. Класс цистода. Sources of infection is cows. Meat from cows. Factors of transmission. Meat from cows. So, in tenia solium, yes, sources of infection is in patients, and intermediates, hosts are pigs, dogs, cats. In teniosis, teniarhynchus saginatus, infection agent, Tenia-rhynchus saginatus. Sources of infection is patient, and intermediate host is cows. Oral mechanism of transmission, alimentary ways of transmission, characterized by abdominal pain, flatulence, diarrhea, constipation, glossitis, headache, dizziness, convulsions, anemia, leukopenia, eosinophilia. Next, Diphyllobotryum latum. Next, Diphyllobotryum latum. Cause formation of Diphyllobotryosis. Diphyllobotryosis. Class cystoda. Class cystoda. Sources of infection is patients and fish eating animals. Fish eating animals. Pigs, bears, foxes. Intermedial host. Fish and crustacean. And clinic of Diphyllobotryosis, asthenic syndrome, headache, dizziness, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and metabolic disorders. So enzymes insufficiency of gastrointestinal system. So decreasing synthesis of enzymes of gastric juice. And formation of endogenous hypovitaminosis, group of B and folic acid. And it caused the formation of megaloblastic hyperchromic anemia. Megaloblastic hyperchromic anemia. Diagnostic analysis of the patients, FISH in analysis. And coproscopia, coprogelmintoscopia, when they indicate gelmints in the feces, invasive effects of the feces. Sometimes when indicates antibodies in blood. And treatments of тениозис, тениаринкозис, дефилобатриозис, билтрицит. Dose is 50 mg on 1 kg, one day, one time. And then repeat course of the treatments up to 2 weeks. In cases of invasive forms of тениозис, in cases of цистицеркозис, we administer билтрицит. We administer Biltricid. Dose is 50 mg on 1 kg of mass of patients. Is 15 mg of Biltricid on 1 kg of mass of patients during 10 days. And then repeat course of the treatments after 2 weeks. Next, gelminthiasis, dirofilariasis. Dirofilaria repens, dirofilaria imitis. Sources of infection is dogs. Factors of infection, of transmission of infection. Bite of mosquitoes. Bite of mosquitoes, Culex, Anopheles, Aedes. When dirofilaria penetrated by doctors, by vessels, and reproduction in blood vessels, and then penetration to subcutaneous tissue. So you see bite of mosquitoes, sources of infection, dogs. At first, dirofilaria penetrate to organism of mosquitoes, reproduction, and then after bite of mosquitoes, dirofilaria penetrate to bile ducts of the patients, reproduction in bile ducts, and then penetration to subcutaneous tissue. And then it was penetrated to the eyes, to the lung, so it caused the formation of different clinical forms of infection. So infection spread in hot climate, tropical climate. So, bite of mosquitoes. And then penetration, dirofilaria to subcutaneous tissue and penetration to the eyes, the lungs, and migration of durafilaria in subcutaneous tissue. So subcutaneous forms here, subcutaneous forms of durafilaria. Eyes forms, you see durafilaria in the eyes. Sclera, in the sclera. In the sclera of the patients. So, after migration is characterized by mechanical destruction of tissue, toxicological reactions, increasing of permeability of blood vessels, formation of hyperemia, edema, itching of skin, and durafilaria rapens infiltrate in subcutaneous tissue, cause increasing of permeability of blood vessels, itching of skin, hyperemia, edema. And durafilaria immediately penetrate to the lung. To the lung, formation of infiltration of the lung, dry cough, pain in the chest, blood admixtures in sputum. Cause the formation of secondary pneumonia with infiltration, productive cough, chest in the pain, dyspnea. So diagnostic of durafiliasis, diagnostic of infection, indication of antibodies. Antibodies to Wolbachia. Wolbachia, it is bacteria, secondary bacteria, which reproduction in durafiliaria. It caused the formation of secondary infection and synthesis of antibodies to Wolbachia. So it is secondary diagnostic of infection. And clinical inspection, inspection of the skin of the patients. And treatment, diethylcarbamazine, 2 mg and 1 kg from 10 up to 30 days. And repeat of the treatments after 2 weeks. So we can administer albendazole and ivermectin. So during 30 days. And then repeat the treatments after 2 weeks. Thank you. Goodbye.